Hey guys, it's Maryann Little from Short Sale Mitigation, and if this is the first time that you are tuning into my channel, you are on my homeowner channel, my default homeowner channel. And if you don't know who I am, we are a negotiation firm in Massachusetts, which we are Massachusetts-based Short Sale Mitigation. Our brokerage in New Hampshire also negotiates short sales in New Hampshire. So we get a small following of people that are looking for advice and assistance in avoiding foreclosure. So one thing that I can let you all know, if you email me, I am happy to email you a copy of our free book that Nick and I just published for homeowners on alternatives to foreclosure options. So if you're in default, let's say you're 2-3 months behind, FYI, your lender can potentially accelerate your loan and call the whole note due. if that happens, this book may be something you want to read. And of course, if you're a homeowner who is in default with no equity, then your options become a little bit more limited. Now, we also work with bankruptcy attorneys. We have a partnership with a bankruptcy attorney where you could file a Chapter 13 and potentially keep your home. There are other options for you, other loss mitigation options for you. But today's video is more about what to do if you're really kind of near the end, where you've tried a loss mitigation, or you've tried a loan modification, you've tried other things, and right now the lender is still geared to come get you. So, and sorry I look the way I do today. I am a busy mom, just like the rest of you. Well, you may not be a mom, but you may be a busy dad or a busy person. And as I've said in some of the other videos, I try to maximize every minute I have in the day. If I'm going to educate and I'm on the road for quite some time, and I am this morning because I had to drop my son off at school, I'm going to teach. I'm going to give you guys the information that you need to work with your lender to do something about your situation. So today's homeowner situation is about homeowners who wait too long. I honestly think if you're in default, you really need to take action, whatever that action may be, within the first 2-3 months. And again, it goes back to the fact that most mortgages have a clause that the lender can accelerate the loan after 90 days. What's important to note about that is even if they accelerate the loan, it doesn't mean you can't do a workout. So you might be able to have the money where you reinstate the loan. But if you're a homeowner and you're at the end and you've tried all the other options, then I think it's really important that you don't wait. And the reason I say that is I can't begin to tell you how many calls I take a week, dozens, where a homeowner has an auction in 5, 6, 7 days, and what do I do, what do I do? It becomes exceedingly hard at that point to get an auction stopped. We've done it, of course we've done it. Certainly have done it with a potential short sale option, but it becomes very, I went too fast. My car yells at me if I go too fast. But it becomes really limited. It becomes very risky at that point if you're 5 to 7 days out from an auction. If you're in default, and I know it's a scary situation, and you've been back and forth with your bank hundreds of times and calling, what do I do, and you're not getting anywhere, then you have to take action. Don't sit back and just let the bank come in and forcefully take the home, which is what a foreclosure is. You want to take action first. You want to be in control of how you dispose of your own home. So it's really important that you do it before they take action, because then things can become really hard. I am working with a wonderful homeowner right now. She waited too long and called me last week. She had 7 days before her auction, and we are doing everything in our power to try to get this auction stopped. And we do have many ways that we do get auctions stopped, but again, every once in a while, you're going to have that lender that says no. Especially if you do a lot of short sales, and we do. I mean, if you're working with somebody and they're saying like, oh, we get every single auction stopped, I would be very wary of working with that person because nobody can do that. But it's important that if you are working with someone, that they do have tips and tricks and tools that'll help you try to at least get a postponement. So we're still working with this woman. She's a lovely lady. Her lender actually sent her a voicemail that said that they would take the principal balance as the payoff on the home. She's desperately trying to find that voicemail right now, and I hope she does. And if she does, we're going to be able to play that back for them because we can get an offer to meet that for them. But don't wait. That is my message for today. If you are in default and you do not have equity, don't just sit back. Don't just let the lender come in and send you the notices. Don't bury your head in the sand. Don't ignore the messages, and don't ignore the letters that you get, because they will come in and forcefully take your property. So it's really important that you don't let that happen. So anyway, if you have questions and if you would like a copy of our free ebook on foreclosure alternatives, email me at Maryann@shortsalemitigation.net. And again, today's video is for homeowners. We do a lot of homeowner videos. I do a ton of agent videos. We work with real estate agents all throughout Massachusetts. We teach CEUs in Massachusetts. Today's video is specific to what should a homeowner do when they are in default, which is do not wait. So email me for a copy of our free book if you would like. Again, Maryann@shortsalemitigation.net, and we'll send that right over to you. And it'll outline some of the alternatives that you can choose that you may be eligible for to avoid foreclosure. If you want to talk to me personally, my number is 978-384-0032. If you have any questions at all, call my number and let me know. Bye, guys. Have a great day, and hope to hear from you soon.